I don't think I could have quite imagined just over 2 years ago when I made the first video about the Colne Valley Viaduct that I'd be here for the very final 1,000th segment being laid. I think just behind me you can see a little gap that's just one segment wide, and very shortly the very final segment will be lowered into that gap to finish the segment laying for the viaduct. I've made a number of videos about the Colne Valley Viaduct over the past 2 years or so, so I won't be going into too much detail about how this massive launching girder behind me works. If you want to see how that works in full, then I'll leave a card in the top to one of those videos, probably the last one. But today we are just celebrating the completion of the segment laying. Behind me, you can just see the segment making its very slow progress. So it got lifted from over here, and it's been lifted up, and now it's been traveling for the last 5 or 10 minutes very gingerly across the viaduct. And then you can see there it's not quite at the right angle, so once it reaches that gap, the gap over there, it's going to be swung 90 degrees and then it'll be gingerly lowered into that gap. So if you haven't seen one of my Colne Valley Viaducts before, this enormous red machine behind me is Dominique. It's known as a launching girder, and for the past 2 years or so, or just over 2 years, it's been laying the segments for the Colne Valley Viaduct, like I mentioned before. 1,000 segments in total, which have been manufactured further north in the precast factory, which is now, obviously that's now wound down with the last segment poured, I believe, a few weeks ago. But I would encourage you to watch my previous videos about the launching girder, because it really is a fascinating piece of equipment. And I'll be kind of sad to see it go, because I followed the progress of this quite closely. Now, obviously, the viaduct itself isn't, it's not fully complete yet. There's still a lot of work to do, but this is a momentous occasion. So I'm not sure if you can just make out behind me, the segment now is being rotated 90 degrees, so it will fit into that slot. It has to be transported kind of the wrong way to get through the actual launching girder itself. Obviously, once it gets to the place where the segment is going to be laid, then it needs to be orientated so it's in the correct orientation. So it looks as if the segment is almost in position to be lowered now. I'm hoping to get a time lapse so you can see this footage sped up. That is my GoPro, which is covered with a poncho behind me. Of course, my GoPro is not waterproof, but I will endeavour to get some time lapse footage so you can see the sped up process, because this is going to take a few minutes from being turned into the correct orientation to being lowered into position. Yeah, I'm not sure if you can quite hear me over the celebratory music, but the segment is about to be lowered, so I'm going to get under the poncho and try and get some time-lapse footage of this lowering. So there we are, that's the very final 1,000th segment installed in place. Now, the eagle-eyed viewers amongst you might notice there is a little bit of a gap. That's not the segment being the wrong size, and that's not an expansion gap either. What will happen is that gap will be filled in situ, so there'll be like some sort of formwork erected around that gap. I think you just about see it. And then that'll be poured in situ just to finalize that final little place. It's just so the final segment can actually fit in, because you wouldn't want just inches or centimeters left to spare when you're working with tolerances like this. But yeah, it all will be perfectly matched, and obviously it's a post-tension structure, so there's some post-tensioning to do. But yeah, that's the segment in place. That's a momentous occasion for this project that's been going on for about 2 years. Although the final segment is now in place, that doesn't mean the work ends. There's still a lot to do, so the parapets have still got to be installed, and obviously after that we've got other things like the actual slab track, the rails, the overhead line equipment and the railway systems as well. So there's still a good couple of years of work left to do before this viaduct is officially finished. But that is sadly, I think, the last job for Dominique. She will now be dismantled, and I don't know what her fate is. Nobody knows yet where she might end up, but I doubt we'll see her again in the UK. It's a bit of a shame because, like I said, I've been following this very closely for the last 2 years, but this big red launching girder will disappear from the landscape over the next couple of months. Not a particularly long video today, it was more about the final segment being lowered into position. I've released several videos about this, like I mentioned before, so if you want to learn more about how the viaduct was built and how Dominique worked, then I'll leave links in the description to those videos and a little card somewhere to one of the main videos, maybe the last video I released. And just before I sign off, I'd like to say a big thank you to the HS2 media team and the Align JV for the site visit to watch this momentous occasion. It really was a privilege, so thank you.